Mayor Jackson?
Yes.
Thank you so much for coming. We're so pleased to be able to honor you for all of the work that you've done. As chair of our club's International Service Committee, I actually have a twofold question. Based on the fact that Rotary is a service organization and the city provides quite a great bit of service, first part, how does today's climate regarding immigration affect the city's efforts to attract immigrants? And the other part of that is going out. What relationships exist between Cleveland and maybe sister cities or other organizations like that?
I'll take the second first. We have, that's why I so much appreciate the Honorary Constable Corps, because they help to make those things just not ceremonial or paperwork, but they help us to kind of understand what can we do to have a closer relationship. When I met with the consul from Ireland just before coming here, they talked about that relationship and talked about how we can build through economic relationship and culture relationship, educational, health, all these things, how we can better understand each other's people and how we can fill in where we can be strong here, but someone else is strong there. So it's very important that we have sister cities, but not just in terms of it being a piece of paperwork or having it designated without any teeth or substance to it. And we work hard to create the substance part of that. The first part of your question was about
immigration.
That is why I'm so happy and sad, but happy is more than sad, that Joe Zimmerman will be leading Global Cleveland. Never had anybody who could be in that position with the kind of passion and drive that he has, and the appreciation and understanding of immigration that he has. And I believe with him there, working with us as a group, and in the city in particular, we can move that ahead. Now, what is our position in terms of the climate? The climate is what it is. Climate is what it is, and I would say the climate we have today and the attitudes that of that climate, in particular with certain groups, is not unique. It just depends on which group it is or whatever time it is. And so we've all come this route. We've all come here not necessarily in the most favorable climate, right? So we just need to stay focused on doing what is right and what we need to do. Now, you have two groups, in my opinion. You have those who are immigrants and those who are immigrants who have options. These are people who can choose to go anywhere they want in any part of the world and in America. And so we as a city have to invite them and make it a welcoming place by creating an environment and creating a professional career path, whatever it is that they need for them to choose Cleveland as the place that they want to be. But we have another group where most of us who our ancestors came from. And that group is a group of refugees, people who have not the choice to be somewhere, but because of something happening somewhere, is forced to be somewhere else. And we have to demonstrate the same level of concern and welcoming for them, even though they may not have the same social or economic status as an immigrant. So we have to demonstrate, and so that will tell us who we are, the least of us, and whether or not we are providing not the welfare and charity opportunity, but providing an opportunity for people to come here to Cleveland, to be absorbed into what we do in Cleveland, to have the kind of tolerance and attitude of diversity that we need to have to make them feel welcome, and then to allow them to do what they do, and that is be themselves in the city that allows for that environment to allow them to be ourselves. But our challenge will be around refugees. We're working on the immigration side. I think we have a lot to offer people in terms of choosing Cleveland to be a place to immigrate to, but refugees is where we need to step up and create an environment that is welcoming for them also.